Picky tea.
So, Michael and Sam, great to have you with us. How long has it been since you last saw each other?
Last time we saw was Sheffield Wednesday, where you came to play against Sheffield Wednesday.
Yeah, that's right.
And yeah, I saw you there. That was years ago.
Yeah, 14 years ago, I reckon.
Oh, my God, man.
You've not aged a bit, so have you? You look so well.
You look good, man.
Oh,
yeah,
it's
Mickey, man.
Oh, thinking back to when you met each other, what were your first impressions? Let's start with you, Michael.
Well, I know Sam was sort of new to the club as I was, really. I think, I'm not sure how many weeks you came before me, but I literally turned up, I think, 3 days before the start of the season. So it's quite difficult coming into the sort of team and the whole club at that point. But I had heard of Sodje before, and I knew he came with, it was like a 6-game ban, I think, at the start of the season, wasn't it? So this guy. But yeah, no, you can see straight away that he's very athletic and very aggressive and skillful as a defender. So for me, sort of being the opposite as a centre-half, I was really looking forward to sort of, you know, a partnership.
What did you think then, Sam, of Michael?
Yeah, I think when I first came, it was different for me because I just came from Africa like 2 years ago. So the culture was different for me. And when Michael came, I think I was a couple of years older than Michael, but he was like more mature, like on point with time, and he, you know, he's used to being a professional. But I wasn't used to being a professional, but I saw him play. It was different. He was different. I was a different kind of player. But yeah, he did some stuff that he doesn't even know now from the first time I met him, and I just loved him from then.
As it's already been mentioned, we had to wait a little while for you two to team up together on the pitch because you had that 6-game suspension.
Sam. Yeah.
Tut tut.
I didn't know. I didn't even know.
What do you mean you didn't even know?
I signed and I didn't even know I was banned. And I couldn't play. I swear. I was just getting booked in at Brentford at Margate. I think I got a sense of like 6 times, 7 times in a row. But hey. Mickey would tell you that was one of my games and I couldn't hold back. I had to go all the way. So, you know.
You did form this amazing partnership. Brentford fans do talk about it fondly. Why do you think you both work so well together, Sam?
I personally think it was, as I said before, it was off the pitch. I really wanted him to do so well. And it's so funny that when we're playing, he might not even know, like, because he plays on the left. And I played on the right side. I was a bit quicker than Michael, you know what I mean? So if the ball goes over Michael, I don't even wait for him to run. I just go. And he knows anyway, and he talks in. And there's one thing that he did, and he always does it. He might not even know. When we're playing, and I do something good, and he turns to me and I go, "So you're too good, you're too good." He just gets, he really got into my head that I really like him for a man. And when I get sent off or when I do something stupid, Michael would never, he wouldn't talk behind my back. Or so it was like, I had too much respect. Even though I was older than him, I had lots of respect for him.
What about you then, Michael? When did you realise this partnership will work? This is clicking.
Yeah, I think probably just because our styles of play were sort of different, that they sort of complemented each other in a sort of funny sort of way. Sam was obviously, yeah, quicker and sort of covered me a little bit, and yeah, I probably had a little bit more experience with the amount of games he'd played, whether it be non-league or whatever, but he still had more games than me, so obviously he was someone I looked up to. And I think it's just one of those partnerships that clicks straight away, and you sort of, you feel it, and it just goes from strength to strength the more games you play.
Martin Allen, I mean, he is a character, obviously. I've had the pleasure of working with Martin a lot, and he's a great guy. But from outsiders looking in on what was happening at Brentford, they'd hear about all these bizarre things that he would do. Was he as bizarre as it was made out to be, Sam? Did he do something?
Worse. I'll tell you a little story. We were doing paintballing. He was on my side. My Allen was on my side. And we're shooting. He got bored. He started shooting me. he's worse than what you guys keep him outside. But you know, I don't know about Terrence. It was for me. It was just normal. It was just he just wanted to win so well, and I think he signed players that he could put together because we were like a family.
Yeah, Michael, how do you look upon your time with Martin Allen? Because obviously you went on to work with other managers, just like Sam has done as well. Was he the most different of any manager you worked with?
For me, I felt he just sort of put an arm around me and sort of really, really taught me the ropes. Because when I first came into the side, I had some really poor games, and he stuck by me, kept playing me, and I managed to sort of come through that early period and sort of start performing well. But yeah, the early days, he definitely helped me out, and throughout the whole 2 years, really, he was absolutely magnificent for me.
Mm. And Sam, what was he like on a match day as a motivator? What kind of things would he say to you on a match day?
I think he treated me differently from everyone else. That's my opinion, 100%. What he does in a match day, I think we're playing, I think it was a playoff game. What he does, he goes to the papers and it cuts away like a striker saying something about me or saying something about Brentford, and they come into his office. He's like, "Sodje, can you imagine? This guy's saying blah, blah, blah." He knew that I could take it. I couldn't take it. Michael Turner is different. Mike was more gentle. So I get all hyped up. Oh, I can't believe he said that. I'm going to kill him. So he's got different ways of, so he would never put the hand arm around me. Never. If I go to him and say, "Oh, Gaffer, I think I'm tired," he'll be like, What? He would never put his hand around me. But he knows, you know, we're different kind of players, and maybe I needed more pushing, a more strong hand. So, but yeah, he treated me differently, I think.
Tell us about what it was like on the pitch. It's really interesting, I think, to know, what were you like with the opposition players, with the opposition strikers?
I think, to be honest, Sodje had a bit of a reputation of being a bit of a sort of nasty guy, really, because honestly, the amount of centre forwards used to come off with like a cut under their eye or a cut head, because Sodje just, it was frightening, really. But no, you had that mad leap, didn't you? You used to sort of step on their back, didn't you, and jump. You was like miles in the air. It was unbelievable. But I think certain centre forwards are certainly, you know, respectful of that and didn't want to get involved in them sort of situations with Sodje, which obviously is, you know, as a centre half partnership, that's obviously good to see when you know, the centre forwards are sort of a little bit weary of you.
People don't know how strong Michael is, though. People don't know how strong he is in the air. Yeah, I can jump, but people don't know how sensible, how wide Michael is. And I think
it was different in that situation, because like you used to jump over the top of centre forwards to head it, and used to stand there and try and hold them off.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Head it.
Like,
again, do you know what I mean? We're so different in that way as well. Like, we both had the ball, but in different ways. So again, they complemented each other.
Exactly. Yeah.
We've got to talk about your favourite games. Can you think back to what your favourite games in a Brentford shirt would be, Sam?
It's funny. I think you'd be very surprised, because I had some good games for Brentford, you know.
Yeah. I know.
Yeah, but I'll pick, because me and Michael played really well, and I'll tell you why I can still remember it. I think it was Hartlepool away. It might be a league game or a FA Cup game, I'm not too sure. And Hartlepool were doing well. They had some good strikers and good team. Me and Michael Turner were just too good. We were winning everything. We were too good. And after the game, I was in the car with my sister driving home into Newcastle. And the news was just saying, "Oh, we've never seen 2.5 that's good as Sam Sodje and Michael Turner." And I think people don't understand that, you know, people might think I would pick the FA Cup against the Southampton, but no, I really enjoyed where me and him really, you know, bullied people and just win games.
And Michael, what about your favourite game? Does anything stand out?
Yeah, probably on the FA Cup run in the first year, really, I'd pick out a couple of games. Luton away, I think, was the third round we had. It was like a wet day, and I remember we had obviously sold our away allocation out. Remember the atmosphere just being spot on, and Luton were obviously a top team in our league. And I think we won 2-0 that day, and it was just an all-round good performance from everyone.
I've got to ask you, you've both spoken so fondly about each other. Maybe we've touched on Sam being late a few times, but did anything drive you mad about your partner in crime in football, Sam?
No, like I said before, he's so gentle, he's so quiet. We're different people. I've got a lot of good things to say about him. He might get a lot of good bad things about me, because I was like, I'm cool. but no, there's nothing to hate about Michael. Michael, like, he probably understood me more. Like, he didn't even get in my space. He was just a gentleman. Even though I was older than him, he had a good head, man. He was quite a guy. You can't even fight with him. What are you going to say to him?
Because he's too nice.
He's too nice, I'm telling you. Sometimes I see someone do something with him on the page, I take it so personal. I'm trying to do the best back for him.
Michael, forget that Sam is here for the moment.
What can I say to that?
Go on, Michael.
No, again, honestly, I don't know what I can say, really. Is
loving you. I think we've gone so well.
What did disappoint me is when Sam left to go to Reading, and like, he left me there. That's what really disappointed
me. See, that's a good one. I can understand that. What was the best thing about playing together with each other, Sam?
It's so funny because me and Michael never talked about football off the pitch. We never. There's no one day I would say to Michael, if he goes right, I'll go left. Never. Sometimes we were in the room, I don't think we spoke about football, but I could just know what he was doing. He's so bad, and even when I watched him play on TV for Sutherland or Hall, I could know what he was doing. I could know what he was about to do. He was weird. So weird.
That's like telepathy and all that sort of stuff.
And sometimes I didn't even wait for him to run, I just go. I just run, I just tackle. And so he's this sport I get sense of every time. But I played with some brilliant centre half all through my career, went on to play for my country, went on to play for, World Cup qualifiers. I would say, not because he's here, honestly, I could just read Michael. I just knew what he was doing. It's weird.
Yeah, I think just the way we clicked as a duo. And I think we're both so determined to play at the highest level possible that, I remember regularly when sometimes we got a training slot, we'd talk about, getting to the next level and, when we get there, what we're going to do and how we're going to be. And like, we're both about, climbing higher, obviously with Brentford, sure. But wherever that... however it takes us, we'll get there in the end. And I think just having that determination with someone alongside you, like Sodje, definitely sort of drove me to achieve things, really.
Yeah. So in some ways, just to finish up then, you both must be so pleased at how both your careers, and I'm talking about Sam when you look at Michael, and Michael when you look at Sam, how you both went on to have these great careers in football.
Yeah, like I said, when Sodje left, I was hugely disappointed. Not only because I lost my centre-half partner, but he's obviously gone on to Premier League. And I felt, that's where I wanted to be. And again, I think that drove me to sort of continue my progress and continue doing well. Looking up to Sodje, going to Reading and playing in the Premier League. I remember watching him on Sky and seeing him do his thing and thinking, that boy deserves that. He's worked so hard and playing alongside of him was a huge privilege.
Sam, what do you think
of
Michael and his career? How you
expected
it to go?
I think people didn't know how good Michael was, man. I knew how good he was. when he went to, I think he went to Hall after Brentford, and people might be surprised. I'm not surprised. Whatever he went on to do, I thought he was a proper captain. Proper. I came to Brentford before him, but he got the handband. I'm thinking, he got the handband, but I was like, how could he go? He was more of a captain than I was, But I'll probably get sent off anyway, but